Hello everybody, and today we're going to connect this MIDI keyboard into an iPad, an iPhone and the computer. But mainly I'm doing this video to show my dad how to connect this MIDI keyboard into the iPad, because he's got an iPad and you can use Garageband to use the piano sounds in Garageband, because he wants to use it as a piano. So this is the Alesis V25. And by the way, this is a great little keyboard to get started with playing a few tunes. It's only got 2 octaves, but a good little thing to get started with. And this feels like almost like a real piano, and the same size keys as a real piano also. But also in this video, we'll show how to use synth sounds as well. We're using GarageBand on the iPad and on the iPhone, and we'll be plugging into Ableton Live Lite on the PC. I've already got Ableton Lite installed into my PC, and Ableton Lite actually comes with this keyboard as well. On this channel, it's mainly guitar focused, but obviously we get some overlaps from time to time, and I actually use MIDI controllers to create synth tracks for my own music, backing tracks, songs, collaborations and so forth. We're not going to go into the ins and outs of what things do, like these pads here and all the knobs and switches. That could be for another day, focusing on MIDI. We just want to plug this in, get some sounds out of it, and away you go. So we've got a USB cable which comes with the Alesis V25, and we plug this end, the square end, into the back of the keyboard or MIDI controller. So that's there. We've got the standard USB end here which we can plug into a socket. So we'll start off with the iPad. Now with the iPad and the iPhone, we'll need one of these adapters. We've got the lightning plug which plugs into the iPad or the iPhone. And then on the other side there, we will put the USB and also the power supply, the Apple power supply lightning adapter, which usually goes straight into your iPad or iPhone. But in this case, it'll be going in to the socket there. So we've got the lightning in and we've got the USB in also. So let's get started with that. So here we are with the iPad. So we'll plug our lead in. The lightning goes in. So of course this is a camera adapter which you can get online. This isn't actually a genuine Apple adapter, so it's up to you whether you buy the real Apple adapters or these copies of the Apple adapter. So obviously these copies are cheaper than the actual Apple camera adapter. Right, now we want to plug in the power supply. We've got our power plugged in there. Power adapter. Lightning cable into the camera adapter. So you probably heard a sound there to let us know that it's charging. So there we are. Now we just plug in our USB lead also, and we're going to GarageBand, select create song, and you can toggle through a load of instruments. In this case, of course, we want to use the keyboard. And we can select Smart Piano. So it's a bit quiet there, and we can just turn the volume up. So obviously I'm not a very good piano player, but you get the gist. So that's plugged in, ready to go. So if we go back, we can actually choose the Alchemy synth. You get some nice synth sounds, which is good. Of course it works up there as well. But you put that to one side, of course, and play away. And it's the same principle with the iPhone. So same again, just plug into the iPhone, same setup. And here we go. All right, so same again, select GarageBand. Same principle. Just need to turn the volume up. Of course, you can plug headphones into the iPhone and you can plug headphones into the iPad also, so you'll probably be familiar with that. Right, so here we go. So obviously that's a synth. Great sounding synth in GarageBand also. So we go back to the piano here on the iPhone, of course. Obviously put that to one side if you want to. And of course on the synth settings you got loads of different sounds. It was great. There's some nice arpeggiators on the synth on GarageBand also. So there we are, excuse my very poor piano skills, if you can call them that at all, as in skills. So with the iPad and iPhone, all you need is this camera adapter, USB plugged in one side with the input of the adapter, the power, and just plug this end into your iPad or iPhone. And there it is. So onto the Windows PC now. And we're going to be plugging into Windows 10, and we won't need this for that. So what we need to do in this case with Windows is to plug into just directly into USB port. I think the keyboard is actually USB 2, but we've got USB 3 here. This is just an extension lead which goes around the back of my computer just into an ordinary USB port, USB 3 in this case. The reason I've done that is because my USB port here is knackered, broken, or it's got a loose connection, so I've just put this lead around the back, so it's just like an ordinary USB, except it's USB 3, but I think this works in USB 2 as well. It's white, it's got a white bit there, and I think that is USB 2. Blue is USB 3. Anyway, we'll plug in. You can see the keyboard's lighting up. Setting up a device, we're setting up V25, so that's the Alesis V25. Device is ready, V25 is set up and ready to go. So what we're going to do is start up Ableton. So starting up Ableton Live 10 Lite, which should come with your Alesis V25. Right, so Ableton Live is up and running. So basically we just want to get an instrument into one of our MIDI channels. And I'm going to go for a pad, which is like a Van Gelis pad. It's called Van the Man. And if you're a Blade Runner fan, you'll recognize the sound. So you can either double click onto the pad or sound that you want, in this case Van the Man pad, or you can drag and drop it into the channel that you're using for MIDI. So you probably recognize that if you're a Blade Runner fan. Not what I'm playing, but the actual, not what I'm playing, but the sound. So there we are, pretty straightforward with Windows 10. Plug it in, obviously start up Ableton, and away you go. If you want me to do another video on the Ableton part, then let me know. But also there's a lot of useful videos on YouTube covering that subject or this subject with Ableton and MIDI keyboards. And they'll probably do a better job than me explaining the whole thing with the MIDI, and they'll probably be able to play their keyboard a lot better than what I can. Because I'm a guitarist, really. Or I try to be a guitarist. So there we are, just a quick video to show how to quickly connect your MIDI keyboard, and in this case the Alesis V25, to various places, iPhone, iPad, and Windows. So there we are, that's it for today. Just a quick video with connecting up the Alesis V25 into the iPad, iPhone, and into Windows 10. Any comments you'd like to leave, just leave them in the comments below, of course, as always. And if you want to add to this video, or if you've got any further questions, just put any comments in the comments below. And that's it. Thanks for watching. See you soon, and over and out for now. Hello? You'll give me £1 million if I press the Windows key with a function key. Okay, here goes.